A spike in jellyfish biting tourists can impact tourism and lead to decline of tourists in Goa. Sea turtles are a very critical part of the food chain in the ocean since they eat up jellyfish. This and other details about sea turtles will be given to people at the Morchi Sea Turtle Trust organized second Goa Sea Turtle Festival, which will be held in Morchi. As part of the festival, several awareness workshops will be held. The workshops will deal with topics such as what are sea turtles and why Goa's four beaches of Morchi, Mandre, Agonda and Galchibag are important as turtle nesting sites. Sarita Fernandez, project lead for Goa Sea Turtle Festival, stated. She added that the female sea turtles return to the same beach where they were born to lay eggs 30 years later.
The nesting season is from October to April and the hatchling go out in May. The peak olive ridley nesting season is also the peak tourism season. That's why protecting turtles is very important.
We are having the festival for the second year this time. Ami ye munche every year kota and try kota yeje. And the importance of this festival is basically to welcome back the female olive ridley sea turtles that come back every year to nest on the same beach where they were born. मुझे मोरजी और अगोंडा और गालजीबाग और मांद्रेम आ फोर टर्टल नेस्टिंग बीचेस तेजे मुझे कासो गेला ते 30 इयर्स बैक ते पोतून इफ दे आर फीमेल तेच बीच आम्ही आत्ता पोतून नेस्टिंग करू सो से इफ फीमेल ऑलिव्ह रिडली हू लेफ्ट गालजीबाग और मोरजिम 30 इयर्स 35 इयर्स बॅक इज नाव अन अडल्ट हॅज मेटेड अँड इज प्रेग्नेंट शी विल कम फ्रॉम एव्हरी पार्ट ऑफ दी ओशन अँड नेस्ट अगेन ऑन मोरजिम अँड गालजीबाग. So this festival is basically to welcome them back to Goa and it's a homecoming, you know, where Goa is welcoming our olive ridleys back to nest and then go back and continue the life cycle.
Okay, what program you are doing for festival?
So Munje, it's a wildlife festival and it's a marine wildlife festival. So we noticed that nobody on the beach, as you can see around, has any idea that this is a turtle nesting beach. You know, to have this information, to know that we are standing, Ami Tets Zaga on Ahag, where Kaso Yatta, like where the turtles come, is a privilege for Goans, for tourists coming to these Goan beaches. So we felt the importance of telling people this. So that is why through the festival, Ami workshops kota, we have a lot of awareness workshops on very important points like what are sea turtles, because there is confusion between sea turtles and freshwater turtles also. So we tell them that, we tell them why Goa's four beaches are so important on the west coast of India, and it is notified under the CRZ and the Wildlife Protection Act also under the government of India. So we found this important to say, and nobody knew what turtles were, and they are responsibility get laya jay. So ami awareness workshops go and very special munji scientists yatta korun, because the knowledge is so deep and so profound that we have to call experts to do these workshops. So we have this for 3 months because yeah, peak nesting season aha, and ye jena tourists yatta, they come and they see left and they be like, this is a turtle nesting site, and they ask us what is it, and that's where conservation actually starts for us here.
Okay, what is the correct time for turtle?
So Kasoyache munje nesting season in Goa is from October to April. Okay. And the hatchling goes up till May. Munje, after nesting, after a mother turtle puts her eggs in the sand, take us 55 to 65 days lagta for it to hatch. So this is the peak nesting season. Unfortunately, it's also the peak tourism season, which is why such projects and such outreach projects are so important in such wildlife habitats.
In 2019, there were 12 olive ridleys which came to nest at Morjim, 18 at Agonda Beach, 2 at Mandrem and 14 at Galjibag. This is a big achievement for Goa Wildlife Conservation, Sarita disclosed.
So last year we got about 12 olive ridleys only on Morjim. We got about 17 or 18 on Agonda. We got about 4 in Galjibag and we got 2 in Mandrem. So total is more than 30-35 nests. So west coast is sporadic olive ridley nesting. And this is a very healthy population of sporadic nests on Goa's beaches. And Goa being such a small state on the west coast, getting so many nests is a very big achievement for Goa's wildlife, marine wildlife in itself.
Okay. And enka the preserve kortala ani save dortala kide precaution
giyunga. Like a preserve, I think The main way
for safety,
The best way to preserve and protect sea turtles is to know about them, honestly, because they are so highly evolved. They have been evolved and they've survived the times of dinosaurs since that period, and they've evolved into this period. So we were not even existing during the dinosaurs period. So they are that old. So they really don't need protection. They know how to protect themselves. I think they need protection from our unawareness. So that is why I would invite you all to come for these workshops, come for these festivals and know about the sea turtles of Goa. And they are so important because if they are not there, they are the apex predator in the food chain, which is why sea turtles and tigers are the same Schedule 1. They are both Schedule 1 species under the Wildlife Protection Act. And if they are not there, we will see the ocean acidifying. So the jellyfish blooms that we recently seen in Goa is a result of lower sea turtle populations, because very few predators eat jellyfish in the sea. Sea turtles are one of those few who eat jellyfish. So when there are no sea turtles, you have a lot of jellyfish blooms and tourism goes down because tourists get stung. Fishermen's nets get spoiled. So they are so important and people don't know these small little, basic factors. And I think your perspective will change when the next time you visit a turtle nesting beach, whether it's Mandrem, Molchem, Agonda or Galjibag, and you know that this is where they come after such a long and difficult journey. This is where they come to continue the life cycle and go back.
For Prime Video Journalist Prasad Polji, Penne.